When applying embroidery to napped fabrics, such as towels, water-soluble stabilizers like Solvi are often used as a topper. This technique is used to keep pile from poking through the stitching. This prevents stitches from getting lost in the fabric and enhances the clarity of fine lettering and details. Embroidery Studio's Laydown Stitch tool automatically generates a light fill to flatten napped fabrics such as terry toweling or fur. As such, it provides a convenient alternative to water-soluble stabilizers, especially with higher production runs. With Laydown Stitch, there is no need to keep stocks of stabilizer on hand. Laydown Stitch also works as a global underlay. This video looks at techniques for using Laydown Stitch in Wilcom's Embroidery Studio software. If you intend to create a laydown fill for an entire design, simply click the Laydown Stitch icon. Alternatively, select a specific object or objects first. There are two main options when using Laydown Stitch: offset shape or standard shape. If standard shape is selected, choose one from the border gallery. Use the preview button to generate the fill without closing. Try different settings until you're happy with the result. Once created, you can select and resize the shape as preferred. If offset shape is selected, a laydown fill will be generated conforming to the boundary of the design or selected objects. Optionally, include holes if you want the nap to show through the non-embroidered sections. Adjust the number of layers and stitch settings for a more or less dense fill. This will depend on nap density. Click OK to confirm and regenerate. The resultant laydown object is placed at the start of the stitching sequence. Further adjust object properties as needed. With Embroidery Studio, auto underlay is usually applied object by object. Default settings are determined by object size and shape and the current auto fabric. Sometimes, however, you may want to apply global underlay to a group of objects. Select the objects and turn off auto underlay. Use outlines and offsets to create a tatami complex fill object, offset by, say, -2 mm. Choose the color you want to use for the underlay. An offset object is generated for these objects and placed after them in the stitching sequence. Apply laydown stitch type and reposition the underlay in the stitching sequence. Access object properties and adjust as necessary. Apply closest join and run the stitch player to study the stitch out. Laydown can be used on its own as an avoid stitch. In this sample, we see how laydown is used to form a background while the toweling pokes through to form an integral part of the design, similar to chenille. Simple outlines frame the rest of the design. For more information about digitizing with Laydown Stitch, refer to the latest Embroidery Studio online help or reference manual.